In this video, I'm going to remove and clean the throttle body.
So I'm going to open the throttle body to be able to clean it, and this thing is obstructing this, and let's see if we can open without this.
But it is not possible to remove the throttle body, and we have to lift up the tank body. Here are the tools you need: 8mm socket to remove the rider's seat, 10mm socket T-wrench, 4 head screwdriver, 2 and 3mm Allen key, and 10mm open end spanner. First, you need to remove the tank scoop. There is a screw beneath it. Remove that. Remove these locks. Just press in the middle and pull the lock out. Now pull the tank scoop out. Use 4mm Allen key to remove the fuel cap. There is one more bolt underneath. Make sure you do not fall your Allen key inside. Pull this out, and the rubber o-ring as well. Remove these screws. Remove this bolt using 10mm socket. There is a two of them on the both sides. Remove this screw as well from both sides, and then lift up the tank panel. Cover the tank hole to avoid anything going inside. To remove the throttle body, first we have to remove the fuel hose, then the fuel injector coupler, FIT coupler, which is also called a solenoid valve, TPS throttle body sensor coupler, throttle cables, canister purge hose, and throttle body joint clamp screw. To remove the fuel hose, first unlock the lock as given in these two steps. Pull the lock down and then pull the hose out. Secure it somewhere. There is a lock inside. The fuel hose wasn't coming out from the other end. The TPS coupler was obstructing the way. Therefore, this has to be removed first. There is a lock on the top. Press that lock and pull the coupler outside to pull that out. There is a dust as well. Now pull the fuel hose out. Now we'll remove the solenoid valve coupler. Again, there is a lock on the top. We have to press that lock and pull at the same time. These couplers are very tight to remove. Remove the throttle cable using 10mm spanner. If you want to see this in detail, watch my video on throttle cable replacing. I will put the link in the description. Now remove the injector coupler. It's quite difficult to work on this so much less space. Remove the canister purge hose, and then we will able to pull the throttle out of the body. Use the Allen key to loosen the screws. Just loosen it, do not remove it completely. Now try to pull the throttle body out. Pull it from the rear first, because the rear hose is made of rubber, which is easy to squeeze, and then take it out from the front. Clean the holes and then insert the cotton inside to avoid anything going inside.
So this is my throttle body, which is, you can see that, too much dirty. It's totally gone black. Opened it first time in 30,000 kilometers. This is the TPS sensor. TPS is basically throttle position sensor. It measures the throttle position. Never ever open this, right? Here we have the diaphragm for the throttle cable. This is the fuel injector. This is the fuel line, and this is the power for the fuel injector. This is the solenoid valve. In Yamaha, they call this FID, fast idle device. What it does is, there is a hole inside this side, and there's another hole this side. What it does when the throttle is fully closed, this valve allows the air to pass through these holes to maintain the idle. when there is load on the bike. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to remove this using the 10 mm spanner. It's too tight. It's something. Now I got it. It's coming out slowly. So we got it out. This is the injector. It cost 5,000 bucks. There are small holes.
This is the idle screw. Open that as well. There is a lot of carbon built up. We have to clean this. I recommend to use throttle body cleaner and spray it. You cannot clean this using the petrol. Use the toothbrush to clean the surface. Do not use any kind of hard scrubber because it will put the scratches on the surface, which will attract even more carbon in the future. Use anything to open the throttle valve. It will be easier to clean. The carbon deposit is very hard. You need to repeat this process several times to be able to clean it. You can see the carbon deposit on the valve edge. This needs to be cleaned perfectly as this will allow the throttle to be closed completely and hence better throttle response. You can buy the injector cleaner from auto parts store. Make sure to buy the injector cleaner and not the carburetor cleaner. It can be injector cleaner or carburetor and injector cleaner both. Spray this on all the holes to clear the carbon deposits. You cannot do this with petrol. Now the results start to show up. Now we can see it's much cleaner than before. I inserted the cotton on the injector pathway and then soak it with the injector cleaner and then clean the hole. Also remove the FID to check for carbon deposits. There is a lot of carbon deposit inside which needs to be cleaned. Spray it in the holes as the air passes through these holes. The cleaner the holes, the better throttle response will be. If you are facing any juddering issue, then remove this FID and clean the holes. Now install the FID back as we have opened it. Clean the idle screw as well. This small screw with O-ring costs 280 rupees. The idle needs to be readjusted after you install it. This is the injector. Clean it from outside. This same spray can also be used to clean the injector as some kind of jugaad needs to be made. This injector O-ring cost 145 rupees. I'm not happy with the job until it is done perfectly. This is done now. This looks so super clean. I'm very happy with the job done. No mechanic outside will do this kind of job. It is you only who can do this. Let me know what you think about this video. I hope I'm leaving you better than before. Hit that like button. Share this video with your friends. I will see you guys in the next video. Take care. Bye bye.